Hi, this is Kashpunisa Bagewari. Welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to talk about Amazon DynamoDB introduction. So this is introductory video for beginners. So in this video, I just want to give brief idea about what is DynamoDB, so you can get started with this. So in this video, I'm going to cover the points like introduction, features, core components, accessing options, and we will have hands-on demo. So let's start with the introduction part. Amazon DynamoDB is fast, flexible, fully managed NoSQL database that provides predictable performance with seamless scalability. So DynamoDB is a fast and flexible and fully managed. So you no need to worry about software installation, configuration, patching, maintenance. And it is NoSQL. So unlike any other relational database, you no need to predefine your schema. It is schemaless. It supports document and key value data structure. It is suitable for applications like mobile, web, gaming, advertising, etc. that need consistent single digit millisecond latency at any scale. For any application like you want consistent performance, and you want very low latency and high scalability, you can go with DynamoDB. It can be used to build modern serverless applications. You can scale up or scale down your table's throughput capacity without downtime or performance degradation. So as your workload demand get increase or decrease, behind the scene DynamoDB scales up and down. So you no need to worry about your downtime and performance degradation. DynamoDB allows you to delete expired items with the help of TTL from tables automatically to help you reduce storage cost. So if you want to delete some items after some specific time, you can set TTL and all your those items will get deleted automatically, and you can save your storage cost. So moving for the next part, features of DynamoDB. DynamoDB is highly available. It automatically replicates data across three availability zones in AWS region. It is durable and scalable. It stores data on SSD. It is fast and flexible. It's suitable for read-heavy application. It is serverless. It supports global replication with global tables. So if you want to store your data globally, so you can, with the help of global table, you can achieve this. It supports ACID. It supports encryption at rest, point in time recovery, and on demand backup. So moving for the next part, core components. So the following are the basic DynamoDB core components like table, items, and attributes. So table is nothing but the collection of items, and item is nothing but the collection of attributes. An attribute is a fundamental data element. So like any other relational database, attribute is nothing but a column or a field, and item is nothing but the row. And collection of rows and column is nothing but the table. So here in this diagram, in this image, you can see this is the one table. Table name is the people, and there are three items, three records are there. So in each item, there are a different number of attributes. So here it is, in the first item, there are four attributes like person ID, last name, first name, and phone number. In the second item, you can see there is one additional field is address. And in the third and last item, it is one more attribute is added. It is nothing but the favorite color. So this is nothing but the example of NoSQL and schema-less database structure. So there is no fixed schema. So there can be multiple attributes, multiple n number of columns, different number of columns can be possible in each item, in each row. So now moving for the primary key. So in this image, you can see the person ID is nothing but a primary key here. So primary key is nothing but a unique identifier of each atom in the table. And DynamoDB supports two types of primary key. One is partition key and second is composite key. So partition key is a simple primary key. It is composed of the single attribute, and composite key is composed of the two attribute. So two attributes are partition key and sort key. So if you use partition key plus sort key, the composition of the both is nothing but the composite key. So you can either use partition key or composite key as your primary key as per your requirement. So moving for the next part, accessing options. So you can access DynamoDB using AWS Management Console, AWS CLI, DynamoDB API, NoSQL Workbench for DynamoDB, IP address ranges, and you can download DynamoDB on your local computer with the help of jar or Apache Maven repository or Docker image. So now hands-on demo. So I'm going to switch to my AWS console. So this is, I am on my DynamoDB console. So you can see actually right now, sorry, I'm not having any table in my DynamoDB. So with this help of DynamoDB console, we can create tables, we can add and query items, and we can monitor and manage our tables. So I'm going to click on this create table to create my first table in DynamoDB. So here, unlike any other relational database, we no need to create the database. So we can directly go ahead and create table. So here is no database concept. So I'm going to create directly table here. And I'm giving name to my table. Suppose it is company and primary key. So as I mentioned before, so DynamoDB support two types of primary key. One is partition key and one is the composite key. So if you want to add partition key plus sort key, then the combination of both is nothing but the composite key. So for this demo purpose, I am going to keep only partition key. So here ID is my partition key. I can select data type for this. Okay, I am taking it as a number. And here you can see here it is table setting. So here there is a default setting. You can use this default setting. In this default setting, what are the options are available? No secondary index. Provision capacity set to 5 read and 5 writes. Basic alarms with 80% upper threshold using SNS topic DynamoDB. And encryption at rest with default encryption type. So you can go with the default setting. Or if I want to check what are the other options are available. So we can see here. If we want to add secondary index, we can add it from here. And for read-write capacity mode, there are two options are available. Provision is default and it is free tier eligible. And we can have on-demand also. So for right now, I am keeping it for provision. And we can set here auto-scaling. So in auto-scaling, for the read and write capacity, we can set here like target utilization, minimum provision capacity and maximum provision capacity. So for this demo purpose, I don't want to enable auto scaling. So I'm going to disable it. And for demo purpose, I want RCU is 1 and WC is 1. And here I can set here encryption at rest. So for encryption address, there are three options available. First is default. So for default, the key is owned by the Amazon DynamoDB. You are not charged any fee for using this CM keys. So all these keys will be managed by DynamoDB. If you don't want to use default, you can select KMS with customer managed key and CMK means AWS managed. Okay, so as per your requirement, you can select any one of this for this demo purpose. I'm keeping it as a default one, and I'm going to click on this create button. So you can see here table is being created. So we need to wait for that. So now our table is created here. So in this table list, we can see here this, my table name. So this is the overview tab. So you can see, check all that table details here. So here nothing but the table name, partition key with data type, sort key, and point in time recovery, and all the other options, whatever all details available here, we can check it here. Now I'm going to add items, add records in our table. So I'm going to show you how we can add items in our table. So we can click on this create item. So here you can see one attribute ID automatically comes here because it is our primary key. So I'm providing here value for this. Now I'm going to add more attributes. Suppose I want to add name of employee. You can click on this plus icon, click on append, and select the data type, whatever you want. So suppose I want to add address. So this is one item I had added. So here you can see this is in tree structure format. We can switch to text format also. So we can see it here. And if you want to in a single line or with indentation, you can change UI as per your comfortable and convenience. And when you click on this DynamoDB JSON, so it shows that data types as well. So n is nothing but the number for each attribute is here showing data type. N is number for ID, a string for this name, and address s for this address. So now I'm going to click on this save button. So now our item is get added here. So if you want to edit this item, we can select this, go to action and edit this. So we can like this edit here. I'm going to add one more item here. So I'm going to duplicate this and I'm going to add one more item in this, like age. So here it is giving me error because I didn't change this ID. So primary key cannot be duplicate. So it should be unique. So I had to change this and now click on save button. Now you can see the another item is added. So you can see here, here is no age, but here is age is there. So this is the schemaless. So that's why the number of attributes can be different in each items, though it is not fixed schema. And you can, if you want to edit the item here, you can change it from here as well. So it will get edited. So for in the action, you can check with the multiple options with duplicate, edit, delete, export to CSV, manage TTL, manage live count, etc. And you want to query your table, you can query from here. So we will see in the next video. So for this video, I think that's it. And if you have any query, can ask me in comment section. I hope you like this video. See you next time. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.